That actually, it says that. Right, I'm done with facts. I just thought that was funny. KFC in Japan.
That's funny. Speaking of, it's a good segue of Christmas tradition. We did something called the Raft Race yesterday, which is
yes,
in a local town called Matlock. There's a river which runs through it, and for 40 years, it started in 1960 something. I think that's 40 years. No, it's not. Is it
1960 something? Well, it's more, dude. It's like 60. Come on. I still
it started
think
in the 60s.
Yeah, yeah, okay. Right.
Yeah, it started in the 60s. So they've been doing this raft race, and we've done it. This would be our fourth year doing it.
So it's Boxing Day Raft Race.
Boxing Day Raft Race. Two of them have been cancelled. One was because of the flood, and then the other one was because of COVID. So this year was our fourth attempt, and it didn't disappoint again. So we had basically the whole vibe is you have to create your own raft. It has to be homemade, 100% homemade. You can't bring a boat or anything like that. So we 2 years ago made a Barbie car. We won it the year previously in a tank that we made.
Nice.
Which was, it weighed as much as a tank, dude. It was built on
did float
it was
though.
Built on the it did float, but it was built on the frame of a gator, you know, those gator car things,
yeah,
for farm vehicle.
Yeah, yeah.
It was built on the frame of a gator, and it was the heaviest thing imaginable. Like, we really struggled to get it in the water, and really struggled getting it out of the water when you're cold as well. But anyway, so this year we had the Barbie car, which was a sort of take on it, but not really. We used a bit of the same shell. We built like there was big plastic drums on ladders.
It looks amazing, man.
You seen the Barbie car?
Yeah, you
car,
sent
you?
Me the Barbie car. Yeah, you should put a clip off of it.
Yeah, I will. I'll put the clip up here. So basically, you go down the river, and recent years, people stand at the side of the river. They throw eggs at you. They throw flour, water bombs, unfortunately, which is horrible because it's plastic. Yeah, my friend got into an argument with someone at the side of water, which was hilarious. But that's by the by. They did stop people throwing flour this year because it makes a real mess of the river, blah, 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 blah. But the sort of the course is quite, it's a mix. It's sort of quite chill river. And then there's rapids where they do sort of kayaking on these rapids. So it's pretty gnarly, dude. Like, when you're in it, it's pretty scary, especially
me.
Yeah,
no doubt. You don't want to get wet, either.
You don't want to get wet and cold. Especially I've got a bit of... I'm a bit nervous. Let's just put it that way. I was pretty scared that morning. I was quiet, let's put it that way.
Yeah.
I don't like water too much anymore. Nah. So then the one worst part of the race is this a weir, which you have to go down. So different years, it's easy, some it's hard, whatever. Some rafts go over it quite easily, some get stuck, etc., etc. So we got to the weir and basically we tilted over it. It's quite a pretty big step, and then it's got like steps after it, which are all made of rock and stuff. So our Barbie car, the front dug in, and then the power of the water sent it over. I was really lucky because I managed to sort of jump out and grab hold of the side of all these like rocks and logs and stuff. And I didn't go down, but my mate, he was stuck inside. So he went over the bars, the raft landed on top of him. It dragged him down the weir underneath this pretty heavy raft.
Oh, and he's got no air underneath. It's not like there's a hollow or anything.
No, it's made of ladders, so you could get your head up, but ultimately, he's stuck under it, dude. He was stuck under it for about a minute.
Oh. So
and he's beat up today. That's the guy I said this morning I was out walking with. Like, he basically dragged him over all the rocks, and it beat him up pretty bad. And obviously, he was pretty scared because he's stuck underneath something in freezing cold water. But he managed to, you know, pop himself up. I'll get Benny to throw the clip up because it is kind of funny, but also at the same time, it's kind of scary.
The start of a 999 thing.
Yeah, pretty much. So, yeah, I managed to... I didn't go down the rapid, down the weir on my head, but...
Well done. Yeah. You made it out. Hey, I'm trying to find... Did we talk about it on here?
Mm.
I can't remember who talked about it. It might have been you. There was a shipwreck, and they just assumed everyone was dead, and then some divers went down. This is like a week after or something.
Right.
Maybe even longer. It might have been 14 days.
Dude, I do
days.
Remember this story.
Yeah, I do. I don't know if we talked about it on the podcast, but I don't have any facts. I can't remember where it was or anything, but the divers go down and there's a guy surviving in there in an air bubble inside the ship. He's like the lone survivor.